Hey folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and these are the amazing Fender Lead guitars. These are the Fender guitars you buy when you've already got a Strat, a Tele, a Jazzmaster, a Jaguar, an Esquire, a Broadcaster, and everything in between. These were originally discontinued nearly 40 years ago, and Fender brought them back a couple of years ago, and I'm yet to do a video on them. So here I am talking about the Lead 2, which has single coil pickups, and the Lead 3, which isn't only beautiful and sparkly and purple, but it's got humbuckers in it as well. These guitars were originally only made in the late 70s, from 79 till 82, I think. Not a very long production run, and they're quite sought after these days. To find an original, you'll be paying a premium. And the originals were quite beginner-ish, let's say. They were made for the junior players out there, the same way like the Les Paul Junior was for the juniors back in the day. These were for the students, the guys and gals starting out, and for those that just kind of wanted something different, as opposed to a Strat or a Telecaster. These were huge in the punk scene as well because of the price and the fact that you stood out from the crowd. They're super versatile too. Besides the fact that the 2's got single coils and the 3 has humbuckers, they've got some very cool switches, which I'll talk about very shortly. They come in a number of amazing colours. Click the link in the description box down below to get yourself to pmtonline.co.uk, where you can check out the myriad of beautiful colours. I just chose the sparkly purple one and the red one because I think they look very, very sexy on camera. So the specs. They feature Alder bodies, so that very familiar kind of Stratocaster resonance and feel. Both the guitars, but as you can see, they're slightly smaller. Like, the body shapes are slightly smaller, but very akin to that double cut Strat thing. They are still a full 25.5-inch scale length, just they're a little bit smaller. Bolt-on Modern C profile maple neck with Laurel fingerboards. There are maple fingerboard variants available, and more of a kind of shrunken Stratocaster style headstock. It's the cool little vintage appointments that I really love, like the tuning keys. They've got the kind of angular buttons on them, which was very akin to late 70s, early 80s Fenders. Down the fingerboard, 9.5-inch radius with 22 medium frets, beautiful things, and the humbuckers are Alnico 2 magnets, so very kind of PAF kind of vintage vibe, and it's Alnico 5 magnets in the single coils. Both have one volume, one tone, string through bridge with 6 individual block saddles. Now the switches, 2 switches on each. One of them, the top one, is a pickup selector, bridge, neck, or both of them. The one below is 3-way on the humbucker one and only 2-way on the Lead 2. They both have the ability to have the pickup as what it's supposed to be, a single coil or a humbucker, or you can phase split them, phase, alter the phase to make it sound a bit honkier, to make it phase invert, that's the correct term. But yeah, you can put them out of phase on both of them, but on the humbucker variant, you have the option to single coil as well, and you can't single coil a single coil. I think that's all the specs. You're hearing it through the PV6505 mini head, Black Star cab, 2-note torpedo into your ears. It's a great little thing. What's cool about these smaller guitars as well, it feels like, they don't feel like toys, but it feels like you can kind of get around them a bit easier and kind of throw them around. They're very solid as well. A bit of a neck humbucker. As a full humbucker, let's single coil it. You get that lovely Fender squawkiness that we're all used to. The single coil makes the most difference. The full humbucker. Single coil. That's out of phase. You got a kind of superstition. Let's hear the single coils now. Some clean single coil tones. As you can see the grain of the alder a lot more on this transparent red variant of the Lead 2. And in the middle position, I say it's only a two-way switch on the 2, you can really hear that phase come in. It's got that kind of gnarly tone which everyone usually associates with Peter Green, but as soon as you say to someone, Brian May, they're like, yeah, that's a Brian May tone. Small for my massive Geordie hands to get up here, but it's fun to play regardless. Ladies and gentlemen, that's all the sights, sounds and specs I can get from the amazing Fender Lead series, the 2 and the 3. Let me know down below in the comments which one you would choose. Would you modify one? Because I can see myself getting that and putting some hot ass pickups in it and covering it in duct tape to make it look punk as anything. So comment down below, which one would you have and why? And what would you do to it? If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTVUK on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music related content. If you want any more information on the Fender Lead series, either one of them, or any Fender for that matter, get your fine self to pmtonline.co.uk or call into one of our forever expanding lovely PMT stores. We are PMT House of Rock on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and now TikTok. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of these with nice filters on. I've been Dagan and I'll see you next time.